Hi, my name is William.
And I'm Karen. We are both architects and design build consultants, and you are welcome to the Master Builder Show.
You know, many times when you are developing your project, many of us wait till when we are ready to actually move to site, and then we run to our architects and say, hey, I need a set of plans, I need some designs, draw me something. But today we are here to educate and teach you that your architect is just more than somebody who draws plans and who designs. In fact, you need to involve your architect right from the idea formation stage. Your architect helps you with things like feasibility all the way to project completion. So today we are going to discuss five factors you need to consider when you are developing a project, especially an investment project.
Yes, and the very first thing we have to look at when we are looking at an investment project is your location. Location, location, location. It is key. Where is the site going to be located, or what site do you have? What is the access to the location? Do you have roads already there? Is a road tarred already? What is the traffic count? How many people come into the site on a daily basis? Another thing you have to look at, is it that the road is such that you have to resurface it, or is not done at all, that you have to now create your own access to the location. Another aspect of the location that you have to look at is the availability of amenities around the site. Utilities like water connection, power connection, waste management facilities, and so on and so forth. These are things that if they're already available on the site, you can save some money. But if you are the one who is now going to have to look at how to construct road to the location, if you are now going to have to look at how you are going to draw power and electricity and water to the location, then that it means that your project cost is going to go a little higher. So your location is important. The site, for example, is it a flat land? Is it a steep slope? Is it rocky? Is it muddy? And all of those things. Is it clay? Does it have some natural resources available already? Is it close to the sea? Does it already have a water body? And so on and so forth. So we have to look at the specifics that the location gives you, or what you are looking for, and then you also have to, then you can determine the location for your project.
Secondly, you need to also consider the demographics of the people that are in the area. If you were developing a project, say you were developing a mall, and you had an idea that, well, I want to develop a mall to, get shops and have people to rent it. You don't just look at, for example, just the number or the population size. You need to consider even their earning income, because you could have a place where there are a large number of people, but they can't actually afford it. So you look at the demographics, you look at the earning income. You even want to consider the movement of people within the day. Is it a place where people move away during the whole day, or is it a place where people during the day are there, or usually they are there at night? These are all important considerations in planning an investment project.
Zoning is another factor. What does the government have to say about the project you are considering? What do the town and country planning offices have to say about what you have in mind? What does the municipal assemblies have to say? What are their restrictions? What are their requirements? Are there any limitations that you need to be aware of before you even zoom in into what project you want to do? So when you are looking at developing a project for an investment, you have to look at zoning. The area that you have in mind, is it already earmarked for what you have in mind already? Or maybe you are thinking about a mall, like William is saying, but the area has been earmarked for residences. Or maybe the area has been earmarked for educational facility. So zoning really matters. And sometimes you also have to look at the height restrictions, for example. The area that you have in mind, assuming you've already zoomed in onto your site, the area that you have in mind, is it an area that allows you to go very high level, or it has limitation as to the number of floors that you can come across? And if it's close to a water body, what are the restrictions? How close can you get to the water body? And so on and so forth. So zoning is another key factor that you have to look at.
Obviously, we all think about money. Your financial considerations is a very important thing. You know, nobody starts a building without counting the cost. In fact, we read it from the Bible. But many of us start projects and we think that, oh, you continue, I'll be building. But most importantly, we need to consider the financial implications. We need to develop a budget. We need to even look at our cash flow. Is the project cost such that we can finance it in 1 year? Can we finance it in 2 years? Do we want to phase out the project? So depending on your cash flow, depending on the budget or the funds available, your architect can advise you, perhaps phase out the project. You understand me? So looking at your finances is very, very, very key.
We also have to look at payback time. So assuming you go for a loan, it's a $5 million project, for example, and you go for a loan, how much time do you have to repay the loan? All of those things will determine the kind of projects that you do. So if you have about 25 years to repay the loan, then obviously you have a lot more time. But the case where you have just 3 or 5 years to give the money back to your lenders, then it means that even the kind of finishes that we propose, the size of the project, all of that, and so that if, when we are looking at phasing out the project, you know that, okay, so after year one, we can start paying back the loan, or after year one, the project can start to generate some income. So in addition to the budget, in addition to the cost analysis, the payback time is also something that you have to look at to help you determine what kind of project you should invest in.
So obviously, when you realize that when you involve your architect at the very inception, at the very idea formation, there's a lot that he brings to the table. For example, even based on your budget and your cash flow, your architect is able to even determine what shape of building you should be doing, because there are some shapes that cost more than certain kinds of shape. There are some areas he looks at, things like your gross floor area, how much of it, for example, if you're doing a rental facility, would be actually rented out and how much it would be for services. So you would realize that it's very important for us to involve our architects right from their idea stage.
Thank you very much for your time. We trust that you've learned quite a bit on how to define your project. We'll see you again next time.